Hi, I am Nirmala Devi, serving as Assistant Professor in the Department of Biochemistry, Biotechnology and Bioinformatics, Avinash Lingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women. You have chosen to do the lesson on fermented soya-based foods. To just look into an overview of it, legumes or pulses are the edible fruits or seeds of pod-bearing plants. The protein content of legumes is quite high, in the range of 20 to 40%, and hence the legumes are important nutritional constituents of diet. In India, the term gram is used to denote dry legumes, while the split decorticated grains are called dal. The principal legumes in India include Bengal gram, red gram or pigeon pea, black gram or urud, green gram or mung bean, peas, lentil, horse gram, cowpea, cluster bean, Indian bean, French bean or kidney bean, and soya bean. Soya bean protein is the most satisfying pulse protein with respect to nutrition. The fermentation process in soya bean products can convert minerals like iron, calcium, magnesium, potassium, selenium, copper and zinc into more soluble forms, which enhances the availability of these nutrients to the physiological and metabolic activities of human. Soybean fermentation can also increases the total amount of vitamin and mineral content in the final product, and some of the yeast that are commonly used during the fermentation process are able to add large quantities of vitamins such as thiamine, nicotinic acid and biotin, making even healthier products from soya bean. Fermented soya bean food products can help in the reduction of cholesterol level, which also retards the progression of atherosclerosis and have a protective effect against the development of degenerative diseases such as cancer. Fermented soya products also improves the overall intestinal and digestive tract health in some people and increases hyaluronic acid, which helps in lubricating joints and reduce the inflammation that are associated with arthritis. Dietary intake of fermented soya-based products also increases the overall bone strength, promotes cardiac health and thus reduces occurrences of several diseases and disorders. The main objective of this module is to learn about the various fermented soya bean products. A variety of soya bean products are common in Asian countries. The readily digestible proteins that are separated from the indigestible ones in the form of soya bean curd or tofu and soya bean milk. Tofu is prepared by grinding soaked beans into an emulsion of a milky fluid, cooking the emulsion and straining. The curd is precipitated from the fluid by adding calcium sulfate. The precipitate is then allowed to settle, collected, washed and finally dried. The off-white color curd has soft texture and can be cut into slabs or slices of required size and finally marketed. The fresh curd obtained from soya bean has protein content in the range of 6 to 18%. Usually it is stored under refrigeration to prolong its shelf life. Soya bean milk, another nutritious product of soya bean, is prepared by grinding the soaked beans in a steam of water to get an emulsion. The emulsion is cooked for about 20 minutes and additives such as sugar, salt, lime, malt and margarin are added. The cooked milk is then homogenized or emulsified. The milk is either consumed fresh or may be spray dried. Soya bean curd and milk are nutritious products, especially for children who cannot digest cow's milk due to lactose intolerance, which is an inherited disorder. Soya bean milk contains lower amount of sodium compared to cow's milk and is therefore good for individuals with high blood pressure. Now let us see the fermented soya bean products. On the basis of development of modern natural sciences, empirical fermentation techniques became a technology, and many of the procedures originally performed for small trades were developed into industrial processes. Fermentation is an important processing method for converting the non-digestible soya bean into a nutritious, easily digestible food products. Shoyu, that is nothing but soya sauce, miso, nothing but soya bean paste, tempeh, natto and humanetto are some of the well-known soya bean based fermented oriental food products. Shoyu is prepared by Koji fermentation using cooked soya beans mixed with ground wheat and inoculated with Aspergillus oryzae. After fermentation, the salt is added and the product is ripened or matured over 6 months to 3 years to leave the sauce with 5-6% of protein content. Miso is prepared by fermenting cooked soya beans mixed with steamed rice or barley and inoculated with Aspergillus oryzae. Fermentation occurs over several days, the rate of fermentation being controlled by adding additives such as salt. The final product with 10% protein content has a paste-like consistency and is used in the preparation of soups or served with rice as dressing or side dish. Miso has anti-aging properties and helps to maintain healthy skin. It also boosts the immune system, lowers the risk of cancer, improves bone health and promotes a healthy nervous system. Tempeh is a highly nutritious food rich in protein and amino acids with strong smell. It is produced by fermenting cooked and mashed soya beans with Rhizobus oryzae. Tempeh reduces cholesterol, increases bone density, reduces menopausal symptoms, promotes muscle recovery and has the same protein quality as meat. It contains high levels of vitamins such as B5, vitamin B6, B3 and B2. Natto with a different flavor is similar to tempeh and is fermented using Bacillus subtilis. It contains the extremely powerful probiotic organism Bacillus subtilis, which has been proven to support the immune system and cardiovascular health. It also enhances the digestion of vitamin K2. In addition to this, natto benefits, it contains a powerful anti-inflammatory enzyme called natto kinase that has been proven to fight against cancer. Humanetto is obtained by fermenting steamed soya beans using a fungus, and the fermented product is sun-dried. The dry product is treated with salt solution and allowed to ferment over another 3 to 12 months. It is again sun-dried before making it ready for consumption. The preparation of many indigenous or traditional fermented foods and beverages remains today as a house art. They are produced in homes, villages and small-scale industries. On the contrary, the preparation of others such as soya sauce has evolved to a biotechnological state and is carried out on a large commercial scale. Legume-based fermented foods are very popular in the Southeast Asia, the Near East and parts of Africa. They form an appreciable part of daily diet of people as a main source of protein, calories and certain vitamins. Preparation of legume-based fermented foods has remained to some extent an art, and their nutritional quality has been of interest to both professionals and laymen. The fermentation process helps not only in improving the organoleptic quality of legumes but also enhances the nutritional quality. This module here elaborately describes the production of various soya-based fermented foods and critically assesses their nutritional quality. Now let us see the production of fermented soya bean products. Among the various legumes and oil seeds, the soya bean is the outstanding source of protein due to its high protein content and the relative ease of its extractability. The soya bean has been intensively studied and many processes have been developed to obtain and modify its protein for special purposes. A food grade flour of about 50% protein is obtained by dehulling and allows low temperature extraction of the oil. Partially defatted flours also available. The defatted flour can be further concentrated in protein by acid washing starch and other components from the acid precipitated protein, or it can be still further concentrated to the isolate stage by dissolving the defatted flour in alkali, filtering, reacidifying and centrifuging the precipitated protein from the whey. The protein isolate can then be modified by enzymes and other treatments to affect its solubility, wipeability and other properties and then sprayed dried. Or the isolate can be dissolved in alkali, forced through the holes of a spinneret and recoagulated into fibers in an acid bath. In this way, meat-like texture can be given to soya protein and used to manufacture meat analogues. The equipment for fiber production and the fibers being gathered in other less costly ways, including extrusion cooking directly from soya flour. In this process, flour of about 50% protein is wetted to about 30-40% moisture and heat coagulated under pressure. Further, texturizing occurs as the dough expands and becomes oriented to the extrusion orifice. The dough is then cut into chunks and dried. Upon reconstitution and cooking, its texture and appearance are remarkably like meat. Such products are less costly than meat and are increasingly being used as a partial replacement for meat in meat-containing mixture. The processing of soya beans into edible protein foods is often associated closely with or related to the grain milling industry. Oil and defatted meal are the main products for animal feed, but present emphasis on protein quantity and quality of food has focused attention on soya bean proteins. Protein products can be in the form of grits, concentrates or isolates. Edible soya bean flour or grits in the form of full fat, low fat or defatted or manufactured from the bean by steaming to inactivate enzymes, cracking, dehulling, oil extraction and grinding. Full fat can be made from dehulled beans by extrusion cooking. Soya flour can be used to produce protein fortified bulgur, sorghum grits, corn soya blends or wheat flour. The usual procedure is to blend the desired products in a commercial mixture. Large quantities of soya cereal blends have been manufactured, especially for export to developing countries to provide high protein diets. Tempeh keder, a fermented product of Indonesia, is prepared by incubating the soaked soya beans at a warm place, which are knitted into compact cake by a fibrous mold mycelium for 1 to 3 days. The cake is then sliced thin and deep fried or used as a meat substitute in soups. Fermented whole soya beans are available commercially in different parts of the world with different trade names. These are consumed with boiled rice or used as a seasoning agent with cooked meat, seafoods and vegetables. Fermented soya bean paste are believed to have been originated in China in 600 AD and are available with different trade names in various parts of the world as miso in Japan, chiang in China and taco in Indonesia and doenjang in Korea. Tempeh is a traditional mold fermented food in Indonesia, though it has also attracted interest in the Netherlands and United States. It is produced from soya beans and is also known as tempeh keder. The process of this production is outlined. Whole clean soya beans are soaked overnight in water to hydrate the beans first. A bacterial fermentation occurring during this stage decreases the pH to 4.5 to 5.3. The hydrated beans are dehulled and the moist cotyledons cooked, a process which pasteurizes the substrate, destroys the trypsin inhibitor and lectins that are contained in the bean and release some of the nutrients required for fungal growth. After cooking, the beans are drained and may be pressed lightly to remove excess moisture before spreading into a shallow bamboo trays and allowed to cool. Starter culture is added either by mixing some tempeh with the cooked soya beans prior to packing in the trays or by sprinkling a spore inoculum prepared by extended incubation of a piece of tempeh onto the beans. The fermentation is invariably a mixed culture of molds, yeast and bacteria, but the most important component appears to be Rhizopus oligospores, although other Rhizopus species and mucus species are often isolated. Over 2 days incubation at ambient temperature of 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, the mycelium develops throughout the mass of beans, knitting it together. During fermentation, the pH rises to around fungal proteases, increases the free amino acid content of the product and lipases hydrolyze over a third of the neutral fat present to free fatty acids. Unlike many fermented foods, tempeh production is not a means of improving the shelf life of its raw material, which is in any case inherently quite stable. Tempeh contains antioxidants which retard the development of rancidity but will keep for only 1 or 2 days, as spornation of the mold discolors the product and a rich ammoniacal disorder develops as proteolysis produce. Fresh tempeh has a pleasant nutty odor and flavor can be consumed in a variety of ways, usually after frying in oil. In addition to improving acceptability, fermentation also improves the nutritional quality of soya beans. In part, this stems from the reduction or removal of various anti-nutritional factors at different stages in the processing. Destruction of the trypsin inhibitor and lectins during cooking of the beans has already been mentioned, and levels of phytic acid which can interfere with mineral nutrients are also reduced by about a third in the course of processing. The notorious ability of beans to produce flatulence is also regarded as an anti-nutritional property and flatulence inducing. Oligosaccharides such as tachyose and raffinose, which are trisaccharides that are partially leached out of the beans during the soaking stage. Despite the extensive proteolytic changes that occur during fermentation, studies have failed to show that the protein in tempeh is more easily digested. With the exception of thiamine, which decreases, other vitamins increase to varying degree during the fermentation process. Vitamin B12, the anti-pernicious anemia factor, shows a remarkable increase, and this is associated with the growth of the bacterium Klebsiella pneumoniae during the fermentation process. The usual source of this vitamin in the diet is the animal products, and it has been suggested that tempeh could be an important source of vitamin B12 for people subsisting on a largely vegetarian diet. Tempeh can be made from a number of different plant materials, including other legumes, cereals and agricultural byproducts. Now let us see the production steps that are involved in the production of soya sauce. Soya sauce can be produced that involves the microbe mold activity in a two-stage fermentation process, as described here in this flowchart. The mold starter used is often known as koji, a Japanese term derived from the Chinese character for moldy grains. In the koji stage, aerobic conditions allow molds to grow on the substrate, producing a range of hydrolytic enzymes necessary for utilizing the macromolecular material present. In the first stage of soya sauce preparation, soaked and cooked soya beans are mixed with roasted, cracked wheat in about equal proportions and inoculated with ten koje or seed koje. This has been previously grown up on a similar mixture of substrates and contains a mixture of strains of Aspergillus oryzae. The molds are then allowed to grow throughout the mass of materials, spread as layers about 5 cm deep for 2 to 3 days at 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. In the second stage, mash or moromi stage, conditions are made anaerobic so no further mold growth can occur. In soya sauce production, this is achieved by mixing the koji with an approximately equal volume of brine to give a final salt concentration of 17 to 20%. Although the molds can no longer grow, the activity of a whole battery of hydrolytic enzymes continues breaking down proteins, polysaccharides and nucleic acid to produce a liquid rich in soluble nutrients. Yeast and lactic acid bacteria dominate the microflora, producing a number of flavor components and converting roughly half of the soluble sugars to lactic acid and ethanol, so that the final soya sauce normally has a pH falling in the range of 4.5 to 4.9 and ethanol and lactic acid contents of 2 to 3% and 1% respectively. The halophilic lactic acid bacterium Tetragenococcus halophilus, formerly known as Pediococcus halophilus, and the yeast Zygosaccharomyces rugosi and Torulopsis have been identified as being important in this stage of fermentation process. The moromi stage can be quite protracted, lasting up to a year more, at the end of which the mash is pressed to remove the solid residues, which may then be mixed with brine to undergo a second fermentation process and produce a lower grade product. The liquid is pasteurized and filtered, possibly after a period of maturation, and then bottled. As soya beans contain high levels of proteins and oligosaccharides but no significant level of simple sugars, fermentation by lactic acid bacteria and yeast requires the exogenous sacrificing enzymes supplied by the koji. Rather, simple steps are involved in the production of soybean paste known as miso in Japan and chiang in China. These include up to 40% of a grain, such as rice or barley, use dry salt rather than brine and employ a shorter fermentation so that the product has the consistency of a paste rather than a liquid. Fermented soybean liquids light brown to black in color with meat-like salty flavors, commonly known as soya sauces, are prepared by hydrolyzing soya beans in China and Korea and mixture of soya beans and wheat in the country Japan using enzymes produced by Aspergillus oryzae in a strong salt solution. These are known as shoyu in Japan, chianyu in China, kikap in Indonesia and kanjang in Korea. Various methods of using soya beans for the preparation of different fermented foods, including soya sauces, were studied. Soya sauce fermentation has been reviewed in detail, indicating the involvement of two distinct basic processes. The first one includes the fermentation with microorganisms, and the other chemical process involves the use of acids to promote the hydrolysis of the ingredients. The microbes used in soya sauce fermentation are molds, Aspergillus oryzae or Aspergillus soyae, homofermentative lactic acid bacteria, Pediococcus cerevisiae or Lactobacillus delbrueckii, and yeasts including Saccharomyces rugosi. Various groups of bacteria and yeast predominate in sequence during the fermentation, producing lactic acid from simple sugars and causing a fall in pH. To conclude this module, the consumption of energy-rich food in developed countries is so high that more and more diseases can be attributed to malnutrition. Unfortunately, most people have too little awareness of nutritional requirements and the relationship of food preference judgments to these needs. Another consideration for future research is the contribution of the enzyme inhibitors in fermentations, in addition to their already discussed significance as anti-nutrients in the finished product. Protease, amylase and other enzyme inhibitors are expected to influence the rate and the extent of important bioconversions that occur during indigenous fermentations. From this perspective, research leading to new fermentation technologies should be sensitive to social and economic factors in developing countries. Rapid displacement of traditional foodstuffs in developing countries with technologies developed in more affluent countries may result in centralized production, distribution problems, less local involvement in food processing, less employment in some areas, less nutritionally adequate substitutions in raw materials, displacement of traditional arts, dependence on importance of equipment and materials, initially require the use of outside consultants and may otherwise not meet local needs as fully as traditional fermented products. On the other hand, indigenous fermentations may have a number of problems, that is, they are uncontrolled and often unhygienic, labor intensive, seen as primitive by some people or normally not integrated into the economic mainstream, difficult to tax, have limited export potential, and in some cases the impact on nutritive value and safety is questionable.